Most people are looking for how do I make a life worth living in retirement with having. And as an individual who knows someone who talks like this all the time, I can say it can be tough at a late stage of life. When we're talking like this, we're talking as an audiocaster, as a podcaster, as a presenter, and as a trainer of sorts. My shtick on homelessness is not from some idea in my mind. It's not from some scientific research. It's not from some medical background. It's from real life experience. When we're talking about homelessness or underemployedness, what do we do when we're faced with a homelessness or struggling individual? What is it that you want to do is not the point. What is it they need done is more important. When we recognize someone else's life, we literally say, I have enough time in my day that I can give up a few minutes to try to help someone on their goals. I'm not saying that we don't help people with food banks, but some places are vile in how they help them. They put them on a point system that barely covers their week. They literally force them into situations where they can't eat the food that's available. And sometimes the people who walk them through those aisles are so pushy, the individual cannot think about what it is that they're trying to buy to keep their body healthy, wealthy, and literally wise. And the fact that the mind has to function. Every human being has different food groups that they can and cannot handle in their physical systems. Too many people in those organizations who are volunteers do not understand that cellular health is the most important health that we actually have as human beings. Our cells do not do well with certain allergy-laden foods. Our bodies do not function well with certain glutens if we are gluten intolerant. If we're allergic to chocolate, we don't want to be constantly solicited to take chocolate pies. It's sort of a joke with some of these people, as if they don't think that an adult has enough understanding about food groups and balanced meals to select the right foods for not only themselves singularly, but also for a family. When I talk like this, I'm talking about real experiences with men in these places who are older, who think that they need to push on us with their attitudes and their ideologies. In one place, I asked just for a question about, could I put my points on hold for a few hours just to wait to see if other foods came in, because I literally cannot open cans because my can openers are constantly stolen, and openly, it's not easy to carry that much food with me. I was really looking for something for breakfast. They offered nothing like that. They certainly offer a lot of cakes and pies, but not everyone can eat those sugars and starches. Not everyone can eat things out of a can, especially corn can run right through a person. There are people who have lactose intolerance, gluten intolerance, and all sorts of allergies, and people don't really think about that. Now, when we're talking about homelessness, we're talking about real life for real people that don't have a home. If you don't have a home, it means you get caught in a torrential rain. If you don't have a home, it means you get caught in freezing cold weather. If you don't have a home, it means you don't have a place to go when it's not able to be anywhere else. What I mean by that is sometimes in life, we have to take time to put ourselves together. We have to take time to take a shower. We have to take time to do laundry. We have to take time to literally get online, because most job applications for any type of employment in the world today is done through online resources. The problem today is that we are paying company for technologies that should, generally speaking, be free. The problem is there are no checks and balances on those technology companies as to whether or not they are actually providing us services in the free realm. They could be just saying we're getting free service, or they could have offered it originally, but they could have changed the fine print many times on us and we would never, ever know. In my case, I'm getting virtually no telephone calls. Long ago, with the same tools, I would get calls multiple times a day through my Google Voice number that would carry over to my cell phone. Nowadays, I'm lucky if I even see a voicemail message. The other day, I know I got one, but by the time I got to it, it had been deleted by some ill-willed employee at a retail establishment where I chose to get on their free Wi-Fi to check my voicemail. When I was literally at the Noblesville Arby's, somebody locked me out of my Kanji Camp, or Japanese language program, voicemail. I had just changed the password and openly had not had a chance in that second that I was doing it to write it down yet, and openly my mind is older. It doesn't function that well under stress, and I've been under a lot of stress with hazing and harassment going on in my life. Now in life we have most of the time to help people, and when I talk about homelessness, I'm talking about it for real. I'm talking about it for as a man who just got caught in a torrential rain because the individual I reached out to say, could you come and help me please, just cannot be mature enough to respond, or her technology is being infiltrated by a force that doesn't want us to have a conversation. There are monsters in this land who think they represent God, but they really don't. They fail Him, Jesus Christ, every single moment of the day. They literally think they are righteous in what they do. They think they are righteous to kick people out of programs. They think they are righteous to trespass people from food. And they openly don't get that they are violently opposed to Jesus Christ in their life. In that regard, they are also legally liable to the Lord. I've talked about this a little bit, but legal liability to God is something very different than legal liability to man. Legal liability to God means He can take your life at any second of the day or night, and you might just end up going earlier than planned. Legal liability to other people means you could be financially indebted to them to millions of dollars for the harassment and hazing on their life. In life, we have moments of time to help someone, and we don't program people without their consent. We don't try to manipulate them, we don't try to take away their rights to their bodies, and we most certainly don't try to shoot them up with things in their food and things in their beverages and things in their bodies without their consent. That is immoral, illicit, illegal behavior that a police officer should know about. And frankly, if you don't know about those things, you're not paying enough attention to the retail employees and their power-hungry need to monkey with someone's life just so they feel alive. In life, we have moments of time to say, stop monkeying around with those men and get here to the people we love. Because in God's house, there are many rooms, is true. But in God's house, there's also repercussions for not listening to the Lord.